Hello. I am back here today. Gonna be finishing up this reaction here, finishing up our journey that we've had here with Childish Gambino. This is gonna be our fourth journey that we are having. Started off with Stone Mountain, pretty cool mixtape. That mixtape led us into some suggestions to listen to Royalty and to finally give because the internet, a listen, because I still hadn't given it a listen, which is pretty fucking whack. But I liked Because the Internet, thought it was pretty good. Wasn't really fucking with Royalty. I really think Stone Mountain came through when it came to that mixtape sound. And overall, out of all these projects, I still think Stone Mountain is the one I like overall. Can't deny catchy pop tracks that are produced to high hell on Because the Internet, though. But Kauai, I'm excited for this. I've only listened to the song Sober on this many times. It's a great track. V3005, Beach Picnic version. I don't know if this is like just a different version of the song from Because the Internet. Maybe it is, I don't know, but let's just fucking get into it. This is easily one of his best songs. Easy.
And now that it's over, I'll never be sober. I couldn't believe, but now I'm so high.
Sincere, just fucking killer.
Girl, what's your problem? Cause I know it's hard sometimes. Maybe just give it some time. Oh, honey, now, girl.
Oh, his vocal abilities on this song are really unmatched, though.
But now I'm so high.
Ooh, that guitar. Very intense industrial, like just bass here. You know, year after Yeezus, okay? Like I've said, I know that Childish, like, definitely looks up to Kanye and Drake, you know, the big heavyweights during the time. I think he definitely took influence. Yeah, when it comes to Sober, I don't really know what to say. Because my experience with the song, because I've known it for quite a few years, is this is just like a perfectly made pop track here. I have really no problems with this song. It's fucking fantastic.
Now that we have found this love, babe.
Very chill wave, like washed out era love. Vibes.
Loving you is all I know, babe. You made me feel so high.
Yeah, he's already talking about, you know, being high from, you know, sexual attraction.
Hold it down. I'm so glad we found it's whenever you like. Make it feel good. Make it feel good. Make it feel good. Alright.
Ooh.
Make it feel good. Make it feel good.
Alright.
Let's go somewhere.
Nice sit there.
Away, babe. When we don't need no.
We don't need no phone. Nice.
Now that we have found
go to some private island.
You'll never be alone.
Ooh. Nice. I always like a vocal exit in the back like that. I don't like the song as much as Sober. Like I but this is still really catchy. It knows what it wants to do.
Best time
was when, well, me and you.
I'm intrigued that this is how I decided to
friends.
Exit out here.
Got a tent. We slept in it. Not the whole night, but just enough time.
okay. I don't know really what to feel about Jaden's part, but that's more so because he's not really given much here. You know, he starts with a spoken word, kind of turns that into a rapping part, and the song ends out. But still, pretty interesting to have a feature like that at, you know, such a young age. Like, if I was 16 and doing that, I mean, I don't even know what the... I'd probably write some stupid shit at 16, to be honest. So that's a lot more grounded and mature. But Pop Thieves, Make It Feel Good. Yeah, this is catchy. This is catchy as shit, actually. I can't deny I was stuck in the environment the whole time. I do think there's a lot of cool rhythms and stuff that happen in the background that, even though it kind of stays repetitious or consistent, it keeps your engagement because of that. It doesn't feel hollow. It feels like there's lots of shit happening. And I like that. Yeah, good stuff. Ooh. Does that often? We can go together, it doesn't really matter. The we fuck? Can get there. Is this the Antlers or fucking Childish Gambino, bro? This beat kind of sounds like something on Stone Mountain, actually. Royalty reference. If she let me slide in, in the A, niggas don't slip and get with a case just for selling it. I know them gorillas, I hang with them killers. They paint them as villains when really they living. We got a bar, this is World War III. I'm the new Jay-Z, I ain't write shit down. I'ma steal that crown, I'ma okay. Do that. I'ma show you how to do this. It's easy when you let go, let go. Didn't mean to make you nervous. The booty looking retro, retro. You could be the moon to me, and I could be spotlight, spotlight. And if you think I'm ballin', you should have seen me last night. Like, the lyrics here are pretty just general stuff. I just like he can keep the consistent energy, but I'm not really worrying about anything he's saying. Gambino vibe, but I also feel like a Battle for More vibe, sort of with this accent. One thing I'm just gonna say too quickly, I just realized the album cover says, like, with Jaden Smith as the boy, so I'm assuming he's playing like a narrative figure in this. First off, in the title of this song, it says rough, so this is a rough cut of a song. That is noticeable. This does feel rough. Not fully engaging with this. It's not bad, but not something I'm really gonna be wanting to come back to or caring about coming back to. Yeah, I don't know how I'll be on a second listen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look what this feeling has done to me. If we could be together, would that make you happy? And if it wouldn't,
some more stuff coming out in the back. Cool exit here. OK, Okay, other than the chorus here on the Palisades, when it comes to Gambino's performance, not really picking up on it. I feel sort of the same about it as I kind of did with Retro. The one thing, though, I'm feeling about this song, though, is I am liking the instrumental, even though I don't think it carries the whole song on its shoulders. I do think it's engaging enough, or I haven't really heard Gambino specifically on something like that. Yeah, it's cool.
I just wanna roll with a cutie one. I ain't trying to catch no feel. No feel. We could get on sometimes. We ain't gotta be sincere. Oh. We ain't gotta laugh so small. Never fade away.
Oh. You just stay the same. Back of this is kind of strange, actually. This is a single hit that's like really taking it, but it sounds so weird when you hear these like female vocals like kind of like ghastly coming out. There's a strange like way to this breaking out though. It doesn't seem as grand as it could have been, but now I'm wondering why he went in this direction.
Say I'm dead wrong, but can you disagree with that? Versace on me, got gold on the V-neck. I'm passing every G-check. Didn't fuck up for a month and never had a reset. It was just then we smoke a blunt and all the drama, it go up in smoke. See, she just graduated, got a new job. Took that nose ring, got her nose, and went and bought a new sob. Got that boyfriend that she living with, and she don't smoke no more. But Joe is cool, I liked her when I knew her back before. Like,
your press is the
See, I like that cymbal and everything, but the drum hit that they have here, the drums in the back, I don't like the way that they sound, though. I'm not liking the way they sound on this. Okay, Poke featuring Steve G. Lover. So this would be my track, like, in the middle ranking of everything I've listened to so far right now. Energy here is a little bit better than Retro in the Palisades. Feature, not bad. Gambino's chorus. I do like Gambino's chorus, but there's just a lot happening instrumentally after the entrance in, that I just don't think I'm picking up on though. So I'm generally just feeling like okay about a lot of these songs so far. Yeah, let's get into the last two tracks here.
One time I was at the beach and we were looking at the stars and this girl was laying next to me and the blanket that we had was had stars on it as well, so the lights were on so we could see what the waves look like.
Okay. I've seen a picture here of what's happening. Okay.
I remember that first night you were wearing a Power Ranger black t-shirt. So was I. But really, we just looked up at the stars for a couple hours, turned off all the lights in the cars. The world was ours, it was yours. And we hope it doesn't end. So we'll drive back to our homes, chilling with our friends.
Ballin' like Jabari Parker, they say I look like him. If we met, bet it would be awkward. Break out the Sudafed. Loco, we could fall out. Nigga, we could fall out. Your girlfriend push a Prius, she giving me that genius. Man,
ahead.
We that Tony Dancer. Wine on the rug, man, you know that shit expensive.
You know that I never wanted to see what's on your mind. Don't you know
that fucking
okay. There's not a lot to this song, really. There's the intro, he does some cheesy bars, comes in with great vocals, and now we're having this another spoken word accent.
Good and bad is all relative, man. It really is.
It's okay, it's just not doing enough for me, though. It's not doing enough.
Funny thing is, man, it's like, as a futurist, and I could call myself a futurist, nobody's gonna give a fuck until I'm gone, so does it even matter? Yes, it does.
Yes, okay. Yeah, Late Night Kauai with Jaden Smith here. Yeah, feeling like this is okay. Not really minding it. It's got a decent vibe to settle in. Gambino knows how to perform, but he's not really saying lyrically anything that I am caring for too much. Yeah. Ooh, pitch corrected. Fuck, bubblegum bass remix. Fucking Childish Gambino. 100 Gex remix. Okay, this song has taken a while to like get into this energy though. It's really just like okay. Okay. Okay, so this really isn't the song. This is just a remix, basically, of like this chorus. It's kind of cool when you get into it, but is it enough as a whole song for me to like want to go back to it often? Not fully. Alrighty. So that was the last song on there. Version 3005. Or 5 3005. Beach Picnic version. And I don't feel that many ways about that. And this project as a whole, I don't feel many ways, actually. First two tracks, though, I do like. And everything else on here, I'm sort of just... it's not fully hitting the mark here for me. Nothing here is bad to me, but the majority of this is definitely missing a lot, especially from Gambino. Performance-wise, you're not really getting a lot bars-wise. I understand that this is him wanting to do more of a R&B vibe, but the R&B vibe is really locked to these specifically set choruses. It doesn't really break out of that, and I only feel the instrumentation works with that on the first two tracks. There's problems, or the instrumentation isn't taking this grandiose nature, which I think it should more, and if it's not going to, then there has to be a reason for it. But here he is trying to go for that vibe, I would say, on the majority of these tracks, besides maybe something like Late Night in Kauai. Thinking right now, I'm not sure, a 6 or a 6.5, that's sort of the range I'm thinking on first listen. I couldn't see it going higher. I couldn't, and I don't think it would go any lower. But I'll let you know after a few more listens. Alrighty, so I've listened to this Kauai EP, Childish Gambino, a few more times. And at the end of the video, I gave it a 6, 6.5. That's sort of how I was feeling. Not much has changed, but I would say I'd keep it at the 6.5. Because this is still pretty light, fun stuff, even when it doesn't blow me away. Because only 7 tracks on here, and it's easily listenable. But I do have problems. Like I said, I still think that the fact that it keeps this R&B vibe, but then trails off, doesn't keep it consistent, doesn't keep production that really fits with it, barring the first two tracks, I do think fit well. So it's just not having all the pieces working together for me. As a full project, I don't think it expands on many things that Childish has done. Stone Mountain, I thought that was better than this, I guess. Most people wouldn't compare them, I suppose. But yeah, not feeling too many ways about this, but you cannot deny that Sober was an instant hit, instant classic. And I'm really glad to still have that. We'll be listening to that on the regular. Anyways, if there's anything you want to see me react to, anything at all, just put a comment down below. And thank you for watching. Peace.